Hi everyone and welcome back to a brand new QuickTip by JANUS Engineering. This week we're gonna take a closer look at once more another turning operation for us. So what about my scenario today? As you see, I have a turning part already clamped to my vise in here, and the turning part is not that suspicious at all. Actually, it has some outer dimensions on it, inner geometries and stuff like that. But when we take a closer look at the inner geometries by hiding my part and taking a closer look at the 2D geometry of the spun outline, we will see the very first challenge for us. We have to finish this hollow section in this middle area. To do so, I will do it as always, make a right click, insert operation. My type is turning. The subtype is gonna be finish turning. I'm picking my pre-selected tool. And when I apply with OK now, I see all the rest material that the previous operations left over in this middle area in here. So, and for this, I also will go to my cut regions in here. And instead of default, I would like to specify my region selection by hand. Because if I do so, I can also show you the very next challenge that we have in here. As you see, that's the tool that I'd like to use to finish this inner geometry. But there's actually no way to get into the inner area without having a crash on the other side with my tool holder. You see that? That's a little bit difficult to get in there. But we of course also have a solution for that. First of all, I will go to my non-cutting moves and begin with the engage movement. I will set the engage type to linear relative to cut, and the length of the linear move shall be 1 millimeter. Then I will go to retract. Instead of arc auto, I will set it to same as engage. The next thing is the approach. And I will begin with the motion to start point. First of all, I am selecting direct. I have to pick a point somewhere, maybe in here. That's where I'd like to begin. And now comes the big trick. I will take a closer look at the approach path as well. Selecting points, and here at reorient tool holder, I will click on variable. So now I have the possibility to specify several points how the engage or the approach path has to look like. And I will begin by putting the very first point somewhere in here maybe. The tool holder is still in this in its direction, like just like before. I will add another point to it, but this time this point is not somewhere placed in this area, it will be placed somewhere in this area. And I also would like to tilt my angle of my tool holder in this direction for 25 degrees in my example in here. And I also would like to change the feed rate. Instead of rapid, it's supposed to be a cut motion now. The next thing is I will add a final position for my tool holder somewhere in here, but this time the tool holder is supposed to be straight again, like so. And once more, instead of a rapid move, it's going to be a cut move. That's it for the approach path. Of course, we have to take a closer look at the departure as well. The departure path has to be set on same as approach. So when I regenerate my tool path, I will get this result in here. So what do we see now? Let me verify it first. We see my tool holder. The next step will be set on the very first point that I have to find. But now you will see the magic. And as you see, the tool holder is getting into the hollow geometry of my part. And it's now finishing the geometry. And while returning, it also will be set correctly on its place. So I will give it another feeds and speed as well. For the RPM, it shall be like 1500 rotations per minute, and the feed rate shall be like 0.08 millimeters per rotation. So that's actually it for me now. The next thing that I'd like to do now, of course, is I would like to see the simulation of that. So simulate machine, the post processor is now creating the NC code for that. And once the post-process is finished, I can start the simulation so that we will see how the machine will behave in real life with that operation. So that's my NC code in here on the right side now. And I can start the simulation. So first of all, the tool will be picked, and now we will see how the machine is behaving. It's quite close, and yet it works. You see now that the tool holder does not touch the part at all, and now the cutting operation will begin in the inner part of this workpiece. Once it's finished, it will be taken out just like defined as well. All right, that's it for today. I hope that this function provides you a more productive workflow on your workpieces. Thank you for your attention, and of course, we appreciate a click on the like button, the subscription button, and all the comments that you leave below. Have a good one, and see you next time. Bye bye.